burden down. We're all comrades as we travel on the way. We share a common gift, our covenant in Christ, and we're going to celebrate His love today. We will sing and celebrate His love today. When we come to join in prayer, let us first confess. We have looked too much to ourselves and loved each other less. Come in, pilgrim, lay a burden down. We're all comrades as we travel on the covenant in Christ, and we're going to celebrate His love today. We will sing and celebrate His love today.
Good morning, friends, and welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. This Mass is offered for the following intentions: soul of Mariam Varkey, deceased members of Vaz family, deceased members of Vegas family, deceased members of Isaac family, thanksgiving to Mother of Perpetual Succor, thanksgiving to Saint Anthony, soul of Samuel Cotta. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The Church in her liturgy today rejoices in Christ, her bridegroom, who will cherish her, delight in her, lavish upon her the many gifts of His Spirit, and transform her into a new creation as He transformed water into wine. The vocation to priesthood and religious life is one of hearing the voice of Jesus and responding to that call. It is a way of serving God, one that brings with it the joy of the gospel.
My dear friends, as we participate in this Eucharist, we ask the Lord to prepare us by forgiving our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet, until her righteousness goes forth as brightness, and her salvation as a burning torch. The nations shall see your righteousness, and all the kings your glory, and you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. You shall no more be termed forsaken, and your land shall no more be termed desolate, but you shall be called, my delight is in her, and your land married. For the Lord delights in you, and your land shall be married. For as a young man marries a young woman, so shall your sons marry you. And as a bridegroom rejoices over the bride, so shall God rejoice over you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm will be, tell among all the peoples the wonders of the Lord. All together.
Tell among all the peoples the wonders of the Lord.
O sing a new song to the Lord. Sing to the Lord all the earth. O sing to the Lord, bless his name. Our response.
Tell among all the peoples the wonders of the Lord.
Proclaim his salvation day by day. Tell among the nations his glory and his wonders among all the peoples. Our response.
Tell among all the peoples the wonders of the Lord.
Give the Lord, you families of peoples. Give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord the glory of his name. Our response.
Tell among all the peoples the wonders of the Lord.
Worship the Lord in his splendor. O tremble before him, all the earth. Say to the nations, the Lord is King. He will judge the people in fairness. Our response.
Tell among all the peoples the wonders of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of service, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same Lord who empowers them all in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For to one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another the ability to distinguish between spirits, to another the various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. All these are empowered by one and the same Spirit, who apportions to each one individually as he wills. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly rise as we prepare our hearts for the gospel. God has called us through the gospel to obtain the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, on the third day, there was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus also was invited to the wedding with his disciples. When the wine ran out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what does this have to do with me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jar with water." And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the master of the feast." So they took it. When the master of the feast tasted the water now become wine and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the master of the feast called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first, and when people have drunk freely, then the poor wine. But you have kept the good wine until now." This, the first of his signs, Jesus did at Cana in Galilee and manifested his glory. And his disciples believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, last week we celebrated the feast of the baptism of Jesus. And we saw how this baptism of Jesus is a revelation, a manifestation, an epiphany. John the Baptist, at the time of the baptism of Jesus, had said that, "I baptize you with water, but the one who comes after me will baptize you with the Spirit and fire." Christian baptism emphasizes the role of the Spirit, very important. Jesus himself emphasized the importance of the Spirit in the life of a believer. When we read John chapter 14 verses 15 to 17, this is what we read about the Spirit. "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever." So he's giving something to them who will be there forever. And this is the Spirit of truth. This is what Jesus says. "I will give you a counselor to be with you forever, even the Spirit of truth." That is the Spirit of truth. Now, the very fact that Jesus is now going to end his public ministry very soon, in chapter 14 we know, is the last days of Jesus. And so he is with his apostles, giving them important teaching. So, the very fact that he is going to give them a counselor, someone who will be there forever, there must be a purpose. And so in the same chapter, when we read verses 25 to 27, he tells them why he is giving them the Spirit. He says to them, "These things I have spoken to you." So I told you, it's like a discourse. He is telling them so many things. And he has been with them during his public ministry. He has done a lot of things. He has said a lot of things. He has taught them a lot of things. "These things I have spoken to you when I am still with you." I am still with you. "But the Counselor, the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all that I have said to you." So what he's saying is this: I have said and done a lot of things in your midst. We know time and again they did not understand. Time and again they are asking one another, what is he saying? They are not able to grasp the full thing. Jesus is aware of this. That is why he says, don't worry. Don't worry. You will not lose anything. The Spirit, when he comes on you, he will guide you. He will help you to understand all that I have said now. So there is nothing to worry. So you see the importance of the Spirit. That is why I think Jesus said, no, all sins will be forgiven for the sin against the Holy Spirit, because he is a Spirit of truth. The Spirit reveals Jesus. The Spirit reveals God. And if you reject the very Spirit, then you have lost God. And so I guess that we are not entering into that argument. Now it comes to St. Paul in today's second reading. He understands the importance of the Spirit. And he tells the people at Corinth the importance of the Spirit. And I'm going to read almost for the second time the second reading so that we understand. It starts with verse 4. Now, there are a variety of gifts, he says, but the same Spirit. So many gifts, but the same Spirit. There is one Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. There is one Lord, one Spirit. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in every one. Okay, in every one, it is the same God, it is the same Spirit that is working. It's not, you know, that you are being influenced by some another God or another Spirit, by another Lord. No, it's the same Lord who gives you this Spirit. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. So, St. Paul says, the church at Corinth was very dynamic. The Spirit was very active in that church. All of them had received special gifts of the Spirit. At the same time, there was also conflicts, you know, with regards to which gift is better than the other. They were arguing. He says, see, understand this. There is one God, there is one Lord, there is one Spirit. The gifts are given by this one God, one Lord, one Spirit. So it's not that different gods and different spirits are working in you. So there must be, if there is one God, then the purpose of the gifts that are given to you also must be one. Correct? The same God is giving you. So the purpose is one. The Spirit is one. And this Spirit is given to you. Don't argue. He says, it is given for the common good. What is the common good? You belong to, as I said, at the time of baptism, we belong to a community. We have our, last week I said, no, we have our private life, yes. But don't forget that at the time of baptism, we belong to this bigger family, the extended family. And I said last time, we have a greater responsibility also towards this extended family. And so, St. Paul very clearly tells that, you know, all the gifts that are given to you are for the common good. You see, the Spirit is choosing each one, giving each one a different gift. But don't think it is for your personal life. For a Christian, there's no personal life, absolute personal life. Okay, you may have, but in general, you belong to a community. And so this awareness must always be there. So the first thing that we must understand by the virtue of baptism, we belong to this bigger family. If we don't, if we are not aware of this, then we come to church with so many people attending, maybe 500, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 is useless, because each one is attending as individual. We need to understand. So I am driving this in your mind. We are all baptized, and that is why. So then he explains what are the various gifts. I'm not going to read again. Various gifts. Gift of tongues, gift of miracles, gift of... all these are healing, prophecy. So many gifts God has given. All these are activated by the one and the same Spirit. Again, he tells them. Who allots to each one individually. Yes, he has given to each one individually. Okay. just as the Spirit chooses. He chooses this gift to him, this gift to him, this gift to him, this gift to him. But all this is for the common good. Today, the church celebrates Vocation Sunday, the calling. The calling is by God through the Spirit. That's what St. Paul tells us, no? The Spirit is calling each one of us. So as we celebrate Vocation Sunday, let us understand that we are told to open to the Spirit and discern our calling. So I hope you have understood this, no? So for every Christian who is baptized, there is a calling for the common good. Okay. Now each one has to discern, reflect, take the help of the Spirit and ask, what is this special gift that I have received, which is for the common good? This is what I have to ask, not for my personal this thing. So today, we must ask this question. And as we are praying for each one of us, because all contribute towards the betterment of the common good, no, of all the people. But today, in a very special way, the church is telling us, we must pray for vocation to the priesthood and religious life. Both priesthood and religious life. In Matthew 9:37-38, Jesus, after speaking to his disciples, he says, then he said to his disciples, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Jesus in his own lifetime prayed for this, that the harvest is plentiful. There are so many people who are seeking God, but there are few, laborers are few. So we need to have people who are committed, you know, to this mission, to this ministry of bringing people to God. And that is the ministry of the priesthood and the religious. The main duty is that, to bring people closer and closer to God, to give them that experience of God in their lives. So we need to pray for that. So this is what the first part of today's sermon. I come to the gospel. We cannot miss the gospel of today. In brief, all of us know, when we come to today's gospel, which presents Mary as a mediator par excellence, let's understand in a few words. The context is the wedding at Cana, the wedding feast at Cana. Mary is invited, Jesus and his disciples are invited, and there they are in that wedding feast. In this report of Jesus' first sign, we are told that it is at Cana that he worked his first sign. Now, in this report, now St. John is reporting this first sign that Jesus worked at Cana in Galilee. The language used at this wedding feast at Cana anticipates Jesus' passion. Already we get a hint of Jesus' passion. Now what is this language? When Jesus says to his mother that his hour has not yet come. His hour has not yet come. You see, Jesus, as I said, his incarnation is for a purpose. He's born like any other person, but not like any other person. We know that he was not born out of flesh, but miraculous birth. No, we are not entering into that. But there was a purpose. There's a particular purpose right from his birth. So this is what he says, the hour has not yet come. He protests against her wishes in language that John will use again when reporting, you know, this Last Supper. Just now we read, no? I read John chapter 14, begins the last journey of Jesus. So it is the Last Supper. So during the Last Supper, Jesus uses these same words. John is using the same words to refer to that hour. Jesus knew that his hour had come. And that is why he washed the feet of his disciples. And he knows that now he is going to face the cross. So already the passion is, a hint is given to the passion at Cana in Galilee. So he's telling his mother I have come for that hour. He's telling indirectly, he's telling his mother, I have come for that hour. My hour has not yet come. He's referring to his passion. So already her hint is given. Throughout the Gospel of John, we see so many things happening to Jesus. But Jesus has never lost control. He is in command. He is always in control. Let us not think that these things are happening because, you know, he is at the mercy of the people. No. When we read for a newcomer, it may be like, oh, these people are doing all these things to him and he is like a lamb, you know, without... No. Jesus is in control. He is in command. All throughout John's Gospel, we'll find that Jesus is in control. Even at his trial, when he's answering Pilate, he's in control. He has not lost control at all. So he knows, he's aware. No one can compel him to do anything. We see that. But in today's Gospel, there is one exception. And that exception is who? Mary. We can't hide this thing, no? There is one exception, and that is Mary. Mary is influential in Jesus' first sign. This is the first sign that he worked at Cana. And so Mary is influential, and we learn something from her. She does not tell Jesus what to do. It's very clear, she does not tell Jesus what to do. She simply presents the need to Jesus, okay? They have no wine. This is all that she tells him. They have no wine. She does not argue and tell. She simply tells the servants. No argument with the son. Quite often in family we have arguments, no? The son, why I should do this? And then the mother will, you know, there is an argument. No, there is no argument at all. There is absolutely no argument at all. She tells the servants, do whatever he tells you. So much confidence. So much of faith. Where did she get this? At the Annunciation. At the Annunciation, she was told that this is not an ordinary child. So she knows already. At the presentation at the temple, Simeon and Anna have said so many things. And the others are saying so many things. At the finding of Jesus in the temple, he is talking to these learned people. So all this has great impact on the faith of Mary. She does not understand everything, but she has that faith, something special. So this is the faith. The church says that because of her assumption and role as mother of all of us, we know that at the time of, you know, Jesus hanging on the cross, he gave his mother to this apostle John, and by doing that he has given the mother to the church. She is our mother. She is the mother of the church. She prays for us. Okay? Interceding on our behalf, just as she did at Cana. You see, at Cana, she understood there was a need. Even today, the apparitions of Mary teach us that, you know, she is concerned. She is concerned and she is intervening all the time. So her apparitions have to be, you know, understood in this context of today's Gospel of Cana. She knows something is wrong and she intervenes. She cannot keep quiet. As a mother, mothers never keep quiet in the family. They are so quick to understand what is happening and they are, you know, intervening. They want to do something. So this is our mother asking the Lord to bestow graces on us as he wills. So, she is the mediatrix of graces. That is what we are. Graces. Why? Because when the angel appeared to Mary, what did the angel say? Hail, full of grace. You see? She is filled with grace. And this is the grace she seeks for you and me. So when we ask for an intercession, we ask for graces. She can fill us with God's graces. For she herself was filled with God's grace. Let us, on this celebration of Vocation Sunday, entrust all the priests and religious to the intercession of Mary. We ask her to intercede for us. May she obtain for us the necessary graces to continue the yes that we have said on the day of our ordination and religious profession. Like Mary, we also, the priest and the religious, also have said yes to God. So we pray that Mary will intercede for us and help us to remain committed to this yes. Amen. We will now make our profession of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Through his first miracle at Cana, Jesus gave us his first sign. Let us implore the Father for all our needs.
Lord, our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. Please repeat.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, the bishops, the priests, and the religious everywhere, that they may faithfully radiate your glory to all people by their exemplary lives and work. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of us, that you, who have empowered with various gifts and talents, that we may use them willingly and joyfully for the good of the community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our communities, that you, Lord, enable us to understand and appreciate the differences that are found among us and yet remain united in your love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are preparing for matrimony, and that keeping the spirit of understanding among them, they may have a happy and fulfilling married life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are currently searching for their vocation in life. May they listen to the voice of the Father speaking in Jesus today. May Mary, the Mother of God, who said, "Do whatever He tells you," inspire them to trust their future to Him with confidence and without hesitation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, as we enter the ordinary time of the liturgical year, help us to be guided by you. Word daily and to partake of your sacraments, so that we may become more and more worthy of our Christian vocation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Oswald our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread one in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just an announcement. From tomorrow, we begin the weekday masses. So the masses will be on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and Friday at 7 p.m. And after this mass, we will have distribution of communion from 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Kindly note, communion distribution on Sunday from 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. This will be there every Sunday. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless all of us. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Great things happen when God meets with us. Great things happen when God makes with us. Great and beautiful, wonderful things. Great things happen when God makes with us. Some find life, some find peace. Some people also find joy. Some see things as they never could before. And some people find that they can now begin to trust. Great things happen when God meets with us. Great things happen when God meets with us. Great and beautiful, wonderful things. Great things happen when God